Secrets of serving drinks. That's the daytime job. And welcome to Secrets, the world's most amazing nightclub, where every night we never know what the hell is going to happen next. And the audiences here, of course, are always suave, elegant, and sober. So how the hell you got in, I have no idea. But you're very welcome. We use people from the audience all the time. Not you at home so much, but you will do. You two volunteers here, table full of fellas. Just come here. Come on, come on, come on. This is means move it, move it, move it. Welcome to the show. What's your name?
Graham.
Graham. Okay, where are you from?
Near Manchester, originally.
And you are?
Bertie,
and where are you from?
From Crowborough.
Crowborough. Step close, fellas. Now, this very important question we ask here. Do you have any spondulics, cash, money, that kind of stuff? What have you got? Very nice. Have you got some more? Oh, yes, you have. Look at that. It's not often you see a man going through the change, is it? Now, here we've got some... Somebody down here got it. And it's, of course, our celebrity for tonight, Ruth. Madoc is in the audience. Nice round of applause for Ruthie. Thank you, Ruthie. Yes. 50 pence. I haven't moved it since I got it off you. Would you remember the date on your 50 pence piece, dear boy? And we are going to mark that in a very special place, all right?
Crowborough.
Okie dokie. Now, what we want you to do is stick on a sticker. Point to a sticker.
That one? Yeah, that one.
Okay, then. You put that on there yourself, on the right in the middle for diddle. Yeah, on the middle for diddle, yes. It's got a pen. What you do now is you put your initials on there, Bertie. Right. All right? You put your initials right in the middle for diddle, clearly and succinctly. So, you have initialed that with... That's very good, isn't it? You don't get many people named after a petrol company. BP.
Yes,
that's you, is it? BP. Yes. What you do is you take his BP... Remember the date on his coin?
1979.
A very good year. 1979, is that right? BP. Now, what you do is you hold that coin up high in the air so nobody can get at it, all right? These are buns, by the way. You want to feel? You just stick that on there, like that, and I want you to stand that, or just hold that there for a second, okay? You happy with that? Say, yes, Paul.
Yes, Paul.
Now, he's got a bun. You've lost the dough. He's got a bun. So what I do is take this and ask you to do the same thing on this side. Just stick it like that, right? Hold that in your hand. Bertie.
Yes.
Crowborough, would you stand on the chair? Shoot, did you say? I hope you said shoot. Yes, right, yes.
Now, I'm wearing brown shoes.
Pardon? Yes, you are, aren't you, dear boy? Yeah.
Sorry, I the one night I put brown shoes on, that's me on stage.
Yes. But they'll remember you, won't they? Just put that, keep that up there. Very Statue of Liberty. Now. Oh, funny. Statue of Liberty would not be seen dead in brown shoes. Now, what do you want? You're just having a good time, aren't you?
Oh, I was actually. Yes, well, go?
Yes, go. Right, what I want you to do is the same as him. You've got 50 pence. Remember some mark on it. Stand on the chair at the same time as remembering a mark and the day and everything, okay?
Yep.
Right, get on there, son. Get on there. Oh, good. Hold it high in the air. Statue of Liberty, you see. Thank you, please. Trying to do a trick here. Now, give me the 50 pence. Right, you've memorised it. Memorised every little detail of the 50 pence piece. There it is, ladies and gentlemen, 50 pence and 50 pence. Up here, the Statue of Liberty. Just checking. Now, over here, if your arm gets tired, you can always change arms, something the Statue of Liberty can't do. Now, you have got that. I want you to imagine this coin is travelling up, like that, okay? Hop. Now, I mentioned before, bread buns are full of dough. Step right down. You memorized it yourself.
Yeah.
What I want you to do is remove the fork. I'll have it back. Thank you very nice. And you split it all open. Just divide it open. Inside there, what have you got?
50 pence piece.
50 pence piece. Would you just check the date for me? Yep.
Yeah.
Initial same and everything?
Same one.
BP. Okay? Bertie the Pierce. You may keep the bun and you go back down into the audience. Nice round of applause. We have got 50 pence here, Bertie Pierce, signed by your good self, okay? What was it, the date?
1979.
Yes. Did you know that when you go to the Statue of Liberty, oh, hi, son. When you go to the Statue of Liberty, you enter at the bottom. All right? No. Near the brown shoes. And what you do is you, which I won't mention, and they go, it goes in, you go in the elevator like this, you see. You like this. Not a lot, but you like it. It goes in the elevator like that, you see, and it goes all the way up. And when it goes up, it had to make a detour, but when it went up, something it doesn't have to do with the Statue of Liberty, Bertie, you now step forth, all right, and what you do now is open the bun yourself. You will recognise your own signature. It's our fork, son. Now, okay.
Okay, can I
open the bun. Inside the bun is a 50 pence piece. I want you to check the date. I want you to check the signature.
It's my signature, and it is 1979.
And it's your 50p. Thank you very much indeed. Nice old applause for Bertie Peel. Keep it yours. Enjoy. That's a nice guy. He forgot about it. Okay, enjoy the close-up magic. See you in a little while with more Cabaret at Secrets.
Excellent. Wasn't that great?
Absolutely.
Would you like to see some real magic?
Yeah.
It's going to cost you. At least £20. Can you help me?
Thanks.
I'll give it back to you in the same condition, that's a promise. Excellent. Actually, this is the very first magic trick I ever learned, so watch closely. Can you all see the Queen's head? Right, she's heads up. Now I'm gonna fold the paper three times, see if you can follow the sequence. You watch closely as well. Here we go. There's the first fold. Now you give it a flick. And a second fold. And another flick. One more for luck. Now the secret is when you unfold it, you now find that Her Majesty is standing on her head. You didn't know she could do handstands, did you? Actually, this is very simple. It's just the way you fold it. And I'll do it again. See if you can follow the sequence. Now you fold it in half. Now, the secret is to fold it over so she's now heads downwards. Fold it over again. And top to bottom for the last time. All that remains now is to unfold it the opposite way around. As a result, the Queen will now be upside down yet again.
It's a fiver, not a £20 note.
Ah, I think an error has crept in.
Absolutely.
Well, let's face it, that's not bad for £15, right?
Absolutely.
Would you like to see it again?
Yes, please.
Yeah? Have you got another 20?
No, you've got my 20.
Well, I did promise to give you the money back in the same condition, so I always like to keep my word. So here we go, my hands are empty. Now remember, bear in mind, it's just an illusion. It's all in the mind. Now, it's not what you see, but rather what you think you see. That creates the wonder and mystery.
Excellent.
Your entertainment pleasure.
Thank you.
Oh, that'll do it perfectly. And what I'm going to do is show you something. You get the, you know the forks I used in the other trick?
Yeah.
You just stick them in like that, and then, not one of them, and you stick it right through the fork like that.
Yep.
And if you nip it in nice and tight, hope it doesn't snap, you can actually balance it on top of the label. Like that.
Please welcome from the United States of America, Nicholas Knight.
City of night, city of night, why?
Take you so long to get ready. I just saw a woman get changed very quickly. Yeah, I want to know, you know, I want to know. Now, many people say to me, Paul, are you truly psychic? Is Mystic Meg in touch with anything? That's what they say to me. Well, you can be truly psychic, but apparently, they say, only if you are the seventh daughter of a seventh daughter. Now, I don't know about you, but I'm not. You might have noticed that, okay? And also, you're a psychic. Well, you gaze into a crystal ball, all right? And a crystal ball is a big, heavy thing. And where do you see the information? Right in the middle. Why bother with the outside? Why not just use the middle? Now, for example, you two guys, okay? All right? I picked on these two guys, so you two guys, come here. Yeah. Yes? That's it. Now, welcome to Secrets, the world's most amazing nightclub stage. You come all the way over there, sir. What's your name?
Darren.
Very nice. And your name?
Martin.
Martin. Yeah. And you know what to do with the chairs, don't you, fellas? Yeah? Because you saw the first trick. All right? Mm-hmm. You sit on them. Yeah. Now, were you listening at all to what I was saying there? Yes?
Yes.
Yes, 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 yes. Now, this, if I just show you, I keep it on this little handkerchief wrapped up clean. This is the very heart, the center of a crystal ball. Pick it up, pick it up, pick it up. Pick it up. Now, have a look in that. Can you see anything in it at all?
Some lines.
The little red lines are there are so that the people at home might get a glimpse. If you hold it very still like that, then they'll be able to see. Otherwise, the glass doesn't show up very well on the telly.
Right.
All right? Just hold it still and they'll try and see it. Now, can you see anything in it? You've looked in both ends.
No, nothing at all.
Do you know why you can see nothing at all?
No.
Because you're not the seventh daughter of a seventh daughter. Place it back upon the pad. However, maybe you have a psychic power anyway. Have you ever had a funny turn?
Occasionally.
Occasionally. Well, take hold of it yourself. Keep hold of it like that in your hand so nobody can get at it. That's important. Now, what I'm going to do now, Debbie, can we have some cards? We're going to test your psychic ability. What was your name again?
Darren.
Great memory. Now, this is a deck of cards, ladies and gentlemen, and I hope you can see they are all different. They're a little bit difficult to shuffle, but I'll try. Give them a shuffle like this, a shuffle like that. Is there no end to this man's talent? We cut the cards like that, cut the card. Would you just put your finger on one card? Lower your hand, the one with the crystal ball centre. Just lower your hand onto a card, doesn't matter which one. That one? You're sure?
Yep.
You don't want to change your mind, so we just do that? Well, you can if you want.
No, that's fine. I like that one.
All right. Okay, right. Now, I'm not going to just take the one you stopped. I'm going to take the next three. Earn, der, three. I only went for 2 weeks. Now, you keep those there. The deck of cards is now no longer needed. It's not often you see an impression of a cow with a deck of cards. Now, you have now got that. All right? You happy?
Yep.
Over here we have a man, face to front, smile, this is television. I'm now going to take one card, the one you stopped at, thank you. And could you just give me the center, look, I'm just, can I take the center? Right, thank you. God, that's steamed up. Now, just come here, nothing in it.
No.
You said so yourself, face to front. Come here, Darren. I want you to look through here and out the other side and tell me, what can you see besides wax?
Four of diamonds.
You can see?
I can see the four of diamonds.
The four of diamonds is absolutely correct. How do you do that? Isn't that amazing? Really? You are the seventh daughter of Mystic Meg. Now, this is... Now, look, I tell you what, that's a bit unfair on you, isn't it, son?
It is
a bit unfair on you. Give me another card. All right, now you sit on it. All right, sit on that. Tilt your head back and open wide. Your mouth.
Don't look my eyes. You see all my fillings.
Tip your head backwards. Come here, Sprout, come here. What I want you to do is I want you to look in this end. Come round here. I want you to look in this end and tell me what you can see. Besides, well, it won't be wax, will it? Anyway, what you do, you just look in there. What can you see? Can you see anything?
Six of spades.
You think you can see the six of spades?
Yeah.
Sir, I don't want to touch it. Stand up to this side. Stand up, take the card. Is it?
Six of spades.
The six of spades, absolutely correct. Wonderful. Would you now, gentlemen, return to your seats? I will keep this above it. Nice round of applause for the men as they go. Chairs gone. Very good. Now, madam, you're sitting in the front row. What's your name?
Karen.
I want you to keep it like that. Hold it like that yourself. I will back away from you. I will turn the one remaining card chosen by the young man from the audience towards you. Point it, look through it, and tell me in a loud and clear voice, Karen, what can you see?
Nothing.
Bit louder, love.
Nothing.
Pardon?
Nothing.
No, what can you see? The card. Can you see anything? You can't see anything?
No.
Oh, turn it over the other way then, love. Yes. Can you see nothing at all? No? Well, you must truly be the seventh daughter of a seventh daughter because there's nothing at all to see. Carry on.
Can I just borrow this, your cocktail umbrella? I'm going to introduce you to the natural enemy of the cocktail umbrella, cigarette lighter. Watch. Ooh, wow. That's a wild one. Of course, it's no use to anyone now, so all you do is you just take it here, push it into the hand, and manages to restore itself. Just like
that. Hi, ladies and gentlemen, good evening. My name's Chris Pratt. I'm going to show you a card trick, but I'm not going to ask you to select a card. This is a bit different. I'm going to shuffle the cards up. I ask you to remember that, because you'll say later he never shuffled them when he really does. And I'll square them up. Now, madam, I'm going to ask you to name a card. Any card you like from the shuffle deck?
Queen of Hearts.
The Queen of Hearts. I know it's in there somewhere. I'll find it for you. Queen of Hearts is just about there. The Queen of Hearts? Queen of Hearts. We'll try another one. Madam, do you have a card in mind?
Four of Diamonds.
The Four of Diamonds. Get it somewhere inside there. Four of Diamonds is just about there. The Four of Diamonds. Four of Diamonds. I'll tell you what, we'll do it a bit differently. We'll split the duties, madam. Think of a number, any number you like.
Seven.
Is there a suit?
Go for clubs, I think.
Clubs. We'll try and find it for you. The Seven of Clubs. Somewhere around about there, the Seven of Clubs.
The Nine of Spades.
The Nine of Spades.
Yes.
Nine of Spades, somewhere around about. Just about there, sir.
Nine of Spades.
There it is.
I hope that young man we've just been watching can get round to you all. That was Chris Pratt. He's the secretary of the Magic Circle, you know. Yes. And circles meet all over the world. For example, in Los Angeles, there is the world-famous Magic Castle. And my next guest, I think I met him there first time out. He's a real funny guy. From Los Angeles, please welcome Mike Caveney.
Good evening, good evening. What you are about to see, my friends, is going to look like magic, when in fact, it is the result of many years of practice with my trusty bow and arrow. And I should point out that when this little stunt works, it's a real heart stopper. And that's where you come in. Your name is?
Michelle.
Michelle, it's very nice to meet you, Michelle, because your job is so simple. All you have to do is pull one of those cards out of the deck. See how simple this is, Michelle? Fine. You could do me a big favor right now, Michelle, if you just take this pen and right across the face of that card, if you would just write the name of the person whom we should contact in case of emergency. It's a legal thing. Do this. Have you done that?
Yeah.
Oh, I will take the pen. Hold up the card. Perhaps they can see which one you have selected. Whose name you wrote on there? Whose name do you put on the card, Michelle?
My mom.
Your mom. Excellent. That's who I was going to call. Is she here tonight?
She is.
Oh, perfect. I will take this card. And something you may not have been aware of, Michelle, is the fact that an ordinary pack of 52 playing cards measures exactly 1/2 of an inch thick. 52 cards, 1/2 inch. Therefore, if I place your card at the 26th position in the deck, your card will be exactly 1/4 of an inch from the top, 1/4 of an inch from the bottom of the deck. You might want to remember some of this. It could be important later. Now, are you right-handed or left-handed?
Right.
Right-handed. Excellent. I want you to hold the cards in your right hand, and I want you to hold them right over your heart, just like that. Whole deck, right over your heart, just... Perfect. Now, by using this tape measure, which you may also hold onto with your other hand, I have measured the distance from the end of this string to the tip of this arrow, and it measures exactly 10 feet. Now, in just a moment, I'm going to position myself 1/4 of an inch less than 10 feet from that pack of cards. I will then fire this poison-tipped arrow into the air. It will flash across the stage. It will strike the pack dead center. The needle-like point will cut a path through the top 25 cards, and when it reaches the 26th card, Michelle's card, it will have reached the end of its line and stop dead. A feat so unbelievable that I would be a fool to even attempt it if I were anything less than the finest archer in all of America. Whoa! Do not provoke me. I am armed and dangerous. Now, Michelle, you look a little worried up here, and I'm telling you, there's nothing to worry about. Remember, I'm an expert. Now, sometimes when I'm a little scared that I might be killed, I have a little something that I fall back on. It helps calm my nerves. Would you be any more comfortable with a blindfold on?
No.
Okay, suit yourself. It works for me. All righty here. Michelle, you've got the tape, right? Tape measure?
Yes.
Tape measure, right there? Perfect. Hang on to that tape. Okay, I'm going to back up right over here. And don't let me walk off the end of this stage, folks. Not again, anyway. Okay, you can move too, Michelle. A little bit right on the tape, right at the 10-foot mark, you're going to see a big black arrow. Right on the tape, big black arrow.
Am I going backwards or forwards?
Well, I'm blindfolded. I don't know. Believe it. At the 10-foot mark, big black arrow right on the tape. You see the arrow?
Yes.
You do see the arrow?
Yes.
Michelle, don't move a muscle. I'm just going to sneak up on you 1/4 of an inch. I'm going to let this go. Be careful. This is going to snap back. You be careful. Yeah, you see that? That's a good way to lose an eye. Here's a better way. Now, Michelle, I'm going to aim by listening to the sound of your voice. I want you to call out, "I'm ready, Mike. Fire now." I'm picking up an echo here. You're not throwing your voice, are you? Hello?
Hello?
Michelle, a little cooperation might keep both of us from dying up here, okay? This is an easy shot for me. You think Paul's gonna bring me all the way from America if he didn't think I could make this shot like 90% of the time? Of course not, that would be stupid. I know shots a lot tougher than this. You folks wanna see a really tough shot, huh?
Yeah, I'll show you a tough shot.
Michelle, hang on to the end of that string. All the way down to the end, hang on good and tight. I will take the pack of cards. You have put Mum's name on one of those cards. We'll put them right down the hopper, just like that. And what was the card that you wrote the name on? Which one was it?
Seven.
Seven of?
Spades.
Spades, it's the 26th card. Hold on tight. Yes, indeed, I have speared an amazing card. An amazing feat, despite your response. No, no. You are waiting to see if it is not just a card, but it is the card. Michelle, is that monster?
It is indeed.
Ladies and gentlemen, it is a fairy tale finish. A little souvenir. Big round of applause for Michelle.
Having a good night, Ruth?
Oh, isn't this great?
Yeah, yeah. Now, we got this. Have you ever heard of Harry Houdini?
Yes, I have.
Right. We like to do things about Houdini somewhere in every series we do.
Yeah.
Would you like to open that little box? It's kind of a jewel box. It opens like that. Open it up.
Right.
Woo! Now, in there, in there's a Houdini coin. Just take it out. Have a look at that. Now, that's a coin that was struck to kind of commemorate the man himself. Can I show it to the public at
home?
Yes,
indeed.
Because if I do that and get it to there, you see, you can see, look at that. That's Harry Houdini. Kind of looks good, doesn't he? Yeah? And on the other side, if I just turn it over, look at that. You've got a pair of handcuffs, because he was known as the Handcuff King, was the kid.
Yes.
And we're going to do a trick with Harry Houdini. Now, pass me one of those serviettes, all right? And over here, I've got one of these. Get it out. Come on, here. This is a pen, and I'm just going to write on there. There's only one, isn't it? Yeah. Prison. All right. Like that, you see? So if I write prison on there, you know that's where he is. Another one, please. Have a different colour.
Right, let's have a pink.
A pretty pink, yeah. And on that, we'll write hotel, fast as we can, like that. Hotel, not my best writing, but it'll have to do for now. Put that back in its holder. Now, over here we have got the hotel, right?
Yes.
He's not there. He's actually over here in the prison. We've got a couple of little glasses that will help keep him trapped. What I want you to do is just put the one on there and one on there. That's it. Trap him. Unbelievably, Houdini used to escape every time from the prison and try to make his way back to his hotel. Every town he went to, for publicity. Now, many people don't believe he could do it. But take off the glass, that one first, and have a look underneath there. Yourself, you do it. And he's disappeared.
Yes.
Yeah. And if, well, he hasn't disappeared, he's actually escaped.
Yeah.
And if you now just lift that up and just take that away. There he is. Harry Houdini, known as the Handcuff King, okay? That was what he was called. He's very famous for that. Now, I'll tell you what else we can do with Harry is, now, we'll use the box. What I want you to do is put the glass upside down on the box. Just do it yourself, right? Do it yourself. Now, we take the coin.
Yes.
That way up.
Oh, that way up.
Yeah, okay. Like that. Okay, we take the coin. Now, you can see, I hope you can see, Harry is on there. All right, can you see
that?
Yes. Yeah? All right?
Oh, yes.
He's on there. Now, watch.
Yes.
Now, the first thing the guy does is he escapes from the handcuffs. Can you see the handcuffs have gone from the coin? Yeah?
Yes.
Got
yes.
that?
Yes.
He's still there himself, but he's escaped from the handcuffs. And if you just lift that off yourself, lift it off and have a look. Have you got it?
Little. Well, look at that. They're the handcuffs.
A little pair of handcuffs?
My goodness.
Beautiful,
me.
Aren't they?
Lovely.
He's a devil, isn't he? Here, give me this again. Let's try something else. If we put the coin back on there like that, and we just do it again like this. Can you see him?
Yes.
When we do that, we find that he escapes in a different kind of way. There he is, all right, gone from there. And in there now, you'll find Harry Houdini, the Handcuff King.
Marvellous.
All right, I'll just see if I can, again, get them so that you can see them clearly.
Yes, and there the cufflinks.
There you go, and that fits right in there.
That's wonderful. That's really wonderful.
Please welcome Genna and Sabrina Kill.
Well, tonight's your lucky night, you see, because with these ladies from the pack, you're going to pick one.
Right.
At random, and I can guarantee you a lot of fun.
Okay.
So, go ahead. Turn one over. Which one did you get? Ah, you've fallen for the woman of mystery, gold digger. Mm-hmm. What's your bank balance like?
Not very good.
Oh, you know when they say when poverty comes through the door, love flies out the window. Mind you, the other queens have interesting characters as well. The loving queen, there's the party girl. She frequents the clubs, you see. Now, we all know what diamonds are to a girl, right? But you know what's interesting? A woman craves attention, so she likes to surround herself with the company of others. Other interests, other passions that can draw her attention. But the most intriguing thing of all I've noticed is that a woman likes to feel she's in charge of a situation. But just when you think you're getting to know her, it's intriguing how she can slip right through your fingers. Yeah. Right through your fingers, just like a wet bar of soap. And look, here's a queen of clubs. Elusive, mysterious, like a magician's illusions. Now you see her, now you don't. Now the loving queen, she lives by the old aphorism, to tease is to please. That's my kind of girl. And before she does that, she completely makes her escape. And last but by no means least is the lady of your choice, the woman of mystery. Seems to me you're very lucky at cards, but unlucky in love. Sad but true. Thank you. Well, let's take the queen of clubs. Now, when she's out in the town, I believe she's going to go for a high roller. And as you know, most high rollers have enjoyed a little flirtation with Lady Luck. Some have other tastes. Look, the lucky seven. I wonder if it will prove lucky for the queen of clubs. Let's have a look. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. Luck, be a lady. Now, the queen of diamonds, when she's dressed up in diamonds and pearls, stands to reason she stands out in the crowd. Ignore her at your peril. Now, here's something really interesting. To claim the affections of a loving queen, you have to appeal to her vanity. See, that's her weakness. And like most girls I know, she just loves the sound of her own name. Look, Q-U-E-E-N. Queen. O-F. Of. That's her middle name. H-E-A-R-T-S. Works every time. But I saved the very best for last. Fate was kind to you once before. I wonder if you'd be lucky again. Touch one. That one there? Gently does it. You wouldn't treat a woman like that, would you? Ah, unlucky at cards, unlucky in love. Well, I did promise you a happy ending, right? And I should have also told you these girls have two faces. And the Queen of Spades is no exception. Thank you.
Well now, ladies and gentlemen, now that I have your undivided attention, let me tell you what this is all about. And I'll tell you what it's all about. In every magic show ever you go to see, you will see a cabinet of this nature. And I've got to tell you something else about this cabinet. They always put a girl in it and then they push rods through, blades through, knives through, something through it. This is the finest example of that kind of box in the world. And I should know, because I've plugged more holes in cabinets than prime ministers. Let's have Debbie. Debbie, up you come. Debbie McGee goes inside the box. She's getting used to it. You step inside there, my little chickadee. Now, those sitting on different angles will see different things. First, we restrain this side. Goes on that side. This one opens up here. Gets clamped up there. Now we put two, one round each ankle. And the chains on the bottom hold her in place. So now, restrain here, restrain there. Now what goes through the box is very interesting. Over here we have the magic circle, all right? Over here we have the a square. And over there the Bermuda Triangle. Now this is what you've got to do. You put them over here, close that, take this, push it there, bang through, and there she's gone. Now, many people don't believe she really has gone. Maybe she just moved someplace. So you take this one. Again, you can see all the way through it. and you place it inside here, like that. You. Oh well, that's that bit dissected. Now the biggie, because a lot of people think, oh well, she's just ducked down there. Well, okay, that goes through there, out there like that. Now of course, she maybe, if she broke out of the restraints, could move to another part of the box. I know what you think. So, what we do is we take two of these. These are steel rods and one goes through here, like that. And this one, it goes through this side, like that. And now we have got two steel rods there, so she can't be there. We take another one. Two gentlemen down there discussing the trick. You're in it next. All right, we take it here, and it goes like that. Now, of course, she can't be here or here. And if we just take that, put that on there. Thank you, Estelle. A lot of people think she stands on here, goes up there, and it's maybe somewhere in there or in there. Other people think they don't really come out the back, but if I angle it like that, the people over that side should be able to see them starting to come out. Thank you, Kim. So if I push this in here and this in here, you'll see the tips of the rods coming out the other side. Okay? Right. Now, two more. And this is called a geometrical illusion. What you're looking at is trigonometry. You take this, put it through here and here. There's now no space left in the box except for Debbie's impression of Madonna. We take these and we put them here. And there is Debbie McGee as Picasso might have sculpted her. So we push those through there. Now, can you really see through these? Well, yes, you can. If we take this and push it through there, that's it. And out the other side it goes. Yep. Another one. So for those who thought she was where she isn't, obviously, tough luck. We put it in here, goes through there, yep. Another one, and the final one goes through here. Can you really see through that cabinet, Mr. Daniels? Well, the answer to that is simple. Yes, you can. You can see right through it, and I can prove it by using a large torch. You can see through that one. You can see through this one, and you really can see all the way through that one. And if I turn it right round, like this, you can see she didn't sneak out the back. You can see over the top of it, you can see underneath it, you can see all round it, so you know there's only one solution. As it has been perforated in every direction, Debbie has disappeared completely. So where could she be? Oh, look, she's over there. No, she's over here. Whoa, there's one. There's two. There's three. There's four. There's five. There's six. Catch them in your teeth. There's seven. There's eight. There's nine. Yo, let's take this out. You almost get the drinks, Stanley. Ladies and gentlemen, that's the end of it for as far as you're concerned at home. Hope you've enjoyed your visit to Secrets, the world's most amazing nightclub. See you next time you drop in. In the meantime, we're going to clear this out of the way, get up, have a dance, have a nice time, jig the night away. See you next time in Secrets. Bye.